I am so new at this. Used to ride a metro. Let us hit us retro. Like the infrareds on my feet, baby. Let's go. Send out your what they know me by.
Hello, everybody. It's your boy Ninja. And today I am going to be talking about something that you guys may have heard of. And if you have, I'm going to be talking about the black market, blackout plans, and free-for-all here on DL3. This is a live commentary for you guys. And yeah, so basically the black market blackout, I'm going to be telling you guys what it is and telling you guys how I feel about it, okay? But basically, let's get started. So yeah, so the black market blackout is basically where people are not going to be spending money on COD points. It started on April 1st, so like 2 days ago, the 4th? Yeah, so it started 3 days ago, actually, my bad. Yeah, they're not going to be buying any COD points at all. They say they're not going to, but yeah, and they're just not going to use the black, or they're still going to buy, they're not going to buy, but they're still going to use the black market. I don't really know why it's called black market blackout if they're still going to use it, though. But anyway, yeah, they're not going to buy any COD points, and they're going to hope that they change the ways of the supply drop systems, because they feel like it's pay to win, and to be honest, it is, but I don't feel like this is the right approach for this. Like Mikey Gaming started it. I don't know if you guys know who he is. I sometimes watch his videos, like not very often though. Like every once in a while, I'll watch a video of his. But yeah, like he has 7,000 subscribers, right? 700,000 subscribers. And like, I'm not saying that, like that's not a lot, because yes, that is definitely a lot. But like, look at Alie, he has like 12 million. T Martin, all those guys, all the big YouTubers. I don't think any of them are doing that, because you know, they want to get caught, right? So they can do openings, and those videos do well on their channel. So I don't think they're gonna be partaking in this. And like, just because like some people are not gonna buy supply drops, doesn't mean that like a whole bunch of people will. And if you play Black Ops 3, you frankly know that. Like, just because like people might be followers and be like, oh, my friend's not gonna buy supply drops, so I'm not going to, and that's their hope. But like, I was watching J-Hub's stream, it was either yesterday or 2 days ago, and he was like, it's false hope, because like, they tried to do this in Advanced Warfare, and they did. And guess what, they're still putting out new weapons to this day for Advanced Warfare. And so like, I don't feel that Activision will actually care, because there's gonna be like, say there's like 50% of people who don't buy it, but there's still gonna be like a lot of people still buying COD points. So it kind of doesn't really, like J-Hub said, it's false hope, man. Yeah. Like, I'm on last gen, as a lot of you guys know, so I don't really even have black market. So us last gen players don't really even have to worry about that, because there aren't any weapons. Like, we really don't barely have anything on last gen, but game's still good, you know, I still like it. But like, it's just them trying to make money, okay? Like, what is it gonna change? Like, okay, they'll put, like, what do you want them to do? Like, make the weapons, like, so you have to, like, pay $5 for the weapons? Because then it is really pay to win. Like, even though there's a 0.8 chance that you'll get a weapon, if you're guaranteed to get a weapon because you buy it, that's basically pay to win. Because, like, oh, you bought the weapon. But then, I guess it's kind of not pay to win, because then everybody will be buying it. So then, who just wants a game with all new weapons? Like, because you know, if you can buy it, everybody and their toaster will be playing with the next-gen weapons. And I frankly don't think that's a smart idea. Like, okay, yeah, you can get a free weapon, that's cool. But like, who's gonna even be playing this game in a couple of months? Like, it's gonna, in November, it's gonna be the next Call of Duty. You'll be playing that, spending money on that. You won't be playing this game. Like, and people are like, oh no, I'm pretty sure I'll still be playing this game And, like, if you are, okay, that's not bad. But, like, the people that are like, oh, yeah, I'm still going to come back to this game, you're really not.